Hello everyone. Today we are going to start chapter 5, that is Introduction to Euclid's Geometry. Euclid was a Greek mathematician. Before we start with the exercises, we should know about these terms. These two terms are very important for this chapter, that is axioms and postulates. You can see I have written 7 here, so axioms are 7 in number and postulates are 4. So let's start with this axiom. Now, first axiom is things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Now, what is this? Let's describe. A is equal to B and C is equal to B. If A is equal to B, C is also equal to B, then A is equal to C. This is what is being said through this statement, that things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Now, the second axiom is, if equals are added to equals, the wholes are equal. Let's take one number, 4. Now, equals are added to equals. So, I can add 1 this side and can add 1 this side also. The whole, that is the result we are getting, is equal. So, this is our second axiom. Now, third is, if equals are subtracted from equals, the remainder are equal. Let's take 3 here. Now, equal, that means the same number will be subtracted from this and this. The result will be equal. Isn't we have done this earlier also? This is nothing new. So now, things which coincide with one another are equal to one another. So let's take a line segment AB and the other line segment CD. Coincide, that means suppose, imagine that C is on A and D is on B. Then we can say that AB is equal to CD. This is what the fourth axiom states. Now, this is the first axiom that says the whole is greater than the part. Is it new? We have already done it when we were doing fraction. That a whole is always equal. This is a whole. Now, this whole is divided into 4 parts. So, this whole, these parts are always smaller than the whole. Or the whole is always greater than the part. Suppose, let's take another example. 2. 2 is a whole. It is always greater than 2 by 3. Or, let's take 2 by 4, 2 by 5. 2 is always greater than the part. This is what is being said. The sixth axiom is, things which are double of the same thing are equal to one another. You can connect it with the first one, that if two things are equal to the third thing, the both are equal to. You remember A is equal to B and C is equal to B. So, B, A is equal to C. This was what I have explained. So now, things which are double of the same thing are equal to one another. Let's take A is equal to 2B, C is equal to 2B, then we can say that A is equal to C. So simple. Now, opposite of this, the seventh axiom says, things which are halves of the same thing are equal to one another. Now, let's take A is equal to